Good evening. The Board of Commissioners meeting is now called to order. Ask Mayor Pro Tem to please lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Heavenly and Almighty Father, we come before you this evening to once again thank you for allowing us to be here. We thank you, God, for you have brought us another day, God, and shown us the way that we should go, God, and we just thank you for that. We thank you, God, for each person who represented you this evening. God, for it shows us that we have people who are concerned about Princeville. We pray this evening, God, that you will lead us and guide us, oh God, in the direction that we should go. Help us, God, to know what you are saying to us when you speak to us, God. We pray right now for every citizen of Princeville, God. We pray that you will bless them in a special way, God. We pray that each one of us will have a Merry Christmas, God, and we will recognize that you are the reason for the season. We pray for each commissioner, mayor, and the town manager, God, right now. We ask, God, that you will help us, oh God, to hear clearly from you what direction you will have us to go for our town. We ask that you keep us, guide us, and we shall be guided. In Jesus' name we pray, and everybody said, amen.
Please remain standing for the Pledge of Allegiance. Thank you very much. Public comments.
Good evening, I'm Angela Mallory Pitt. I'm from 210 Sugg Street in Princeville. Since the North Carolina legislators have met and decided what funds will be allocated for flood recovery, has the town of Princeville made its decision which, if any, of the three options of the hazard mitigation to participate in? And if not, when will the decision be made and how will it be made? I know that you can't respond now, but I hope that it will be addressed tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Mr. Cecil Body.
I'm not up here to take up a lot of y'all's time. I just need to know some information. Is it going to be a sellout or a buyout, or what is it going to be?
The town of Princeville is going to remain. We're looking at individual cases now.
Okay, that's what I want to know.
Yeah. I think it's Betty Hunter or Hinton.
How y'all doing, Board?
How you doing?
I'm more concerned about the town. I know we paying out more money we bring in, and I want to know if possible the commission could cut back public work, keep one, save some money, because we're going to have problems because we're paying out more money than we bring in. And Mr. Gerald, town manager, he contracted in February of March. Don't you think it'd be needed for to go ahead and start out sending a resume out for another town manager? The cost is too high. and we want to bring it down, we quite sure we can get another town manager to work cheaper and less expense. Because we're looking at, if we keep spending the way we're doing, we're looking at ALGC going to be looking at our back in June, because we're spending out more money we're bringing in. Let's go ahead and do it right now before 2017 come in. Let's start cutting back. Because we don't have that much going on now. The people picking up the debris, and I don't see none of our public work out there raking up behind them, cleaning. And I'm going to go ahead and lay them off and bring them back first of spring. And I think that would be good. And we could save the town a bunch of money. Because I ain't heard nobody say how much we got in our budget, or how much we're paying out, or what coming in. And it's time to start looking at the issue now for 2017 coming in. And I thank you.
Okay. Thank you, Mr. Strard. Mr. Dancy?
I'm going to stay up now. Just want to say I'm on the visit the long-term flood committee meeting in Rocky Mountain at the Red Cross about 2 weeks ago. And we're going to have the next meeting in Tarboro. So I just want anybody, if you need to talk to someone about what's going on, try to get you all the information in our emails, and try to get your questions answered. So my number is 252-314-5484. I haven't gotten the minutes from the last meeting, but as soon as I do, I'll be able to tell you exactly what we're going to do. That was my first meeting. I understand it was one in 99, but I don't know who was on it. But I'm going to follow this one here, make sure everybody, get what they need to get. Because I went to that meeting, and I'm glad I did, because I was basically the only one there from Edgehill County. The manager had to leave. And emergency management manager there, but he had to leave also. But I talked to what I thought was the priority after listening to the people in Edgecombe County. It was like only one or two people in Nash County and Wilson County that was flooded. They was talking about having a meeting at Englewood Baptist Church on Nash County side the next time. Well, one of the FEMA representatives said, we need to go to Edgecombe County. So I didn't say anything to the end of the meeting. I was waiting for them to send out an email so I could send in an email. I like to document stuff. So we are going to have the meeting in Tarboro on January the 11th at 9 o'clock. I'm going to try to make it that we can have it every meeting in Tarboro, because that's where we need to be. So, just like I said, if you need it, got any questions, you can contact me. Another thing, I went to the lawyers' meeting last week at the Holiday Inn or whatever the hotel is. And someone there told me that they had shut down the DRC. And I didn't know that because they told me it was going to be extended. So I sent out an email when I got home, well, before I left the meeting, and I found out they was going to open it back up, and they opened it up at the health department. So I was able to get the information right then and some other information. So if you need me, just give a call. I'll be glad.
Mr. Dance, what's the name of that committee?
It's the Long-Term Flood Recovery
Committee. Long-Term Flood Recovery Committee.
Uh-huh. And they're meeting in different counties. I think Goldsboro. But like I said, I'll get all that information, but we'll be meeting in Tarboro.
You said that's January 11th, 9?
Right.
And
Michael Angel's.
Okay.
Recovery. And I thought it was the best place to have it since it's a recovery center, distribution center.
Is that same one we own?
Yes. 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 Yes.
Are there any additions or deletions to the agenda?
Mr. Mayor, I do have an addition to add to discuss and the board make a decision on the mitigation options tonight.
To discuss and make a decision, or just to discuss?
To make a decision.
No, they have not met with their ward yet.
But I've been calling my ward,
okay,
and I got a consensus that they want to participate in all three of them. And I think that we should decide tonight whether to be unanimous in allowing the people to participate in all three of these options. I second it if you need me to second.
Commissioner?
Table and talk about it. weather so we can get more concrete information. Let us do our lead work first.
Anybody know where Commissioner Ransome is?
Yes.
Says the flu. Okay. So I think we're going to have to let him meet with his ward and then come back and make a decision.
There's a motion on the board on the table.
No, that was just to discuss it, right?
I said to discuss it and to vote on it.
Okay.
Well, it's not a certain motion right now. Okay. You just add it to the agenda.
Mm-hmm. You are adding it to the agenda. You have to make a motion to add it to the agenda. You have to be second if you vote it out.
What about the attorney?
She can't. She's not.
Okay, there's a motion and a second on the floor that we add the mitigation process to the agenda to the, for discussion and or to vote. Are there questions? All in favor, use the voting sign, aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Ayes have it. We'll add that to new business B under the donation center. Okay. Is there a motion to approve the consent agenda?
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
The proper moved and second that we approve the consent agenda. Are there questions? All in favor, use the voting sign, aye.
Aye.
Opposed, nay. Ayes have it. Thank you very much. Next item on the agenda is the Princeville Donation Center.
Yes. Thank you, Mayor, Council members. I have before you tonight a proposal to increase the donation center amount from $1,800 to $2,500. We were unable to get IGA to complete their construction on the building, so we had to move on to Belk's Center. Right now we're at capacity and are turning away the donations because of capacity issues. So I have a contract from the Belk's department store, so give me the authority to do $2,500. That's what we'll do. This is outside of the budget. This has not been budgeted for. That's why I'm coming back asking the board for the budget amendment. We are asking also FEMA to reimburse. We did find paperwork stating that they would reimburse for such issues. So we're in the negotiating process of that into Category A, Category B functions of FEMA.
Okay.
Any other comments? Town Manager, you said you wanted us to approve $2,500.
Right.
Okay. Before we get to that part, do we have a staff or volunteers to help receive these items? And it's going to be a while before the people are ready to move back, so do you think we need to discuss this? Because if we start receiving a lot of items and no place or no procedure of how to distribute them, we're going to be giving away $2,500. Could be for quite a while.
Well, that's a good point. I'm going to recommend that we do it no longer than a year. We do have a staff in place. Ms. Johnson is doing the day-to-day. Calvin is over the entire project. So we do have staff. It's a volunteer staff that we have in place. So the issue now is how long to hold it open, to have the donation center open, because we are still receiving any goods.
Did you try to negotiate that price with Belk?
That was negotiated down.
Okay.
He said $3,800, and we got it to $2,500.
Can I like to be on that committee? Whenever whoever's going to look, Mrs. Johnson's coordinating committee.
Yes.
I'd like to be involved in that process to make sure.
I don't have a problem.
Any other questions? Is there a motion to withdraw the offer from IGA and to allow the staff to contact Riverside Plaza and make an offer?
So moved.
Second. It's probably moved and second that we allow the town manager to withdraw the offer from IGA and allow him to contact Riverside Plaza to make an offer. Are there questions? All in favor, use the voting sign, aye. Opposed, nay. Ayes have it. Thank you very much. Next, we'll move to the mitigation process for discussion. Okay. You want to add that to the agenda?
As long as I can speak on it tonight, yeah.
You want to do it during the...
Mayor comment.
Your comment.
During the comment.
All right. Okay. Okay. Floor is open for mitigation discussion.
I have a mitigation statement for the town. There are three mitigation options. Residential hazard mitigation efforts in Princeville will include the elevation of homes, the acquisition and buyout of homes, and mitigation reconstruction of homes. Elevating a home is the physical raising of an existing structure above base flood level.
Mr. Manager, excuse me, please. We have some those on that. All these people need to hand get in their hands. One to a house, please.
The elevating of the home is physical raising of an existing structure to an elevation above the base flood level or higher, required by FEMA or local ordinances. This project will pay for all engineering to determine if the home is feasible to raise and then elevates the home. The next is the acquisition or buyout of homes. Funds are used to purchase this structure from a willing landowner. This is an opportunity. The homeowner is offered a pre-disaster fair market value for their structure, which is determined by a certified appraiser. The home is then demolished and the land is deeded to the local government and restricted to open space. The property must have a clear title. Land must remain open in perpetuity, to conserve natural floodplain functions. Before the homeowner receives any funds from the selling of the home, all individual assistance or flood assistance not used to repair the home will be deducted from the balance due to the owner. If the owner still owes a mortgage on the home, the amount will be deducted as well. Homeowners are strongly encouraged to keep all receipts and all repairs they have made to their home. And lastly, you have mitigation construction. This is the construction of an improved code-compliant elevated home where the home has been partially demolished or destroyed by floodwaters. This option is available to those whose homes are eligible for elevation, but however, due to deferred maintenance or storm damage to the foundation, the home will not survive being lifted. So the home will be demolished and built back new and then lifted. North Carolina Emergency Management will be working closely with governments regarding this program and grant proposals. The grant proposals will be written through the North Carolina Emergency Management Association. This is designed for long term and also is designed to protect lives and property from future disasters. That's our statement. So those are the three. So you have the raising of your home. If it can stand being raised, you have the demolishing of your home. You hear me? You have the raising of your home. If your home can be raised and is physically strong enough to be raised, you have, that's one mitigation. The second mitigation, if your home is not strong enough to be raised, they'll tear it down, build you a new home, and raise it above base flood elevation. And the third, you can take the buyout or take the land acquisition.
What if you have cement floors?
That's going to be mitigated or looked at by the engineers. If they can get underneath it and jack it up, they'll jack it up. So it's just whether or not they can get the jacks underneath your house.
If that's your personal home or rental property?
That's whoever owns the home. Whoever owns the home and wants to seek that type of mitigation. Whoever owns it.
Are you talking about grants?
Yes, these are all grants. These are all grants, and how it works, the emergency management for North Carolina, they're going to take in the names of the people who are interested in the program. Excuse me. They're going to write the grant to FEMA based on how many people are participating. Then FEMA gives the grants to the state, and then the state issues the grants out through the town.
My question is, the ones that need a house condemned and want to buy out, how would that work? Do the town demolish that home?
If those are two different things. If you want to, if you want to have your house bought out, the demolition will be taken care of as a part of that process.
Oh, okay. Yeah, that's absolutely. Thank you.
How are you come up on the house got to be when you do?
I can't confirm how high it's going to be. We're waiting right now. I have not gotten enough information back from the state to confirm how high the base flood is. Previously, it was 44 feet. Now, that's not 44 feet in the air. That's just the highest ground in Princeville is 44 feet above the base flood level. So let's say this was my house on a hill and your house was here. You'd have to build your house up like that. That's what I'm saying. And somebody's house would be right here. They wouldn't have to build it up as high. They just have to build it like that. But this is the highest one.
You said 44 feet or inches?
44 feet.
No,
44. No, it's 44 feet above the sea level. That's what base flood level. So 44 feet. But your house is not going to be 44 feet. Your house may only be 36 feet above sea level. See what I'm saying? So you're not going to, you're above base flood level. So you're not going to see a house 44 feet in the air.
No, yeah.
That's not what you're going to see. The average distance is going to be anywhere between 2 to 12 feet.
That's what they need to know. That's what they
need to know. When you're going to have that estimate?
I'm on the state right now. I'm going to call them again tomorrow. I'll send them three emails. I haven't gotten confirmation on how high it's supposed to be.
If the homeowner decides to use that grant, do you got a number year like when the 99 flood was, which I heard, I don't know, they got these grants, and after 10 years, I mean that the state owned the houses, and after 10 years, they give you back your deed. You got to give them your deed and all that stuff.
There's nothing like, whatever you did in 99, there's nothing like that. Whatever happened here in 99, the system is not the same. When they give you, if you want to do the raising of your home, once you go through that process, because it's not overnight, but once you go through that process, then validating your home, coming up with a plan to raise and all that, once they do that, they're going to give a grant to the owner, and then a contractor will come in and lift and raise your home, and then you pay them through the grant. So you don't have to, it's not like where the town is going to own your lease.
Yeah.
You know, it's not going to be like that. You're going to immediately have it. So that new house will be rent free, it'll be new. Now, if you have a mortgage or debt on it, I mean, you still pay it, but you would have a new house or a raised structure protecting you from any high water. So you would have an asset that was fixed free of charge.
The buyout, how long would it take and what procedures we would need to take?
All of this is over a period of time.
I think she said
18 months.
Yeah.
So it's not anything immediate.
I'll ask you another question. You saw a double wide, you think it might be condemned? They would tear it down and build you another home.
Right.
Would it be a margin home, a stick built home, a double wide?
It has to be equal to whatever they tore down. It has to be equal to whatever they torn down. It can't be bigger. It can't be, like, you can't ask for a 3-story house and just have a modular home. They're not going to do that. If you had a modular home, they're going to tear down the modular home and rebuild the modular home. If it can, if it can't stand being raised. So first thing that they're going to do is look and see if it can stand to be raised first. They're going to look at that option first.
But also, isn't it true that if you receive flood money for flood insurance, that if you're going to get your house either torn down, you have to use that flood insurance money first, and you're not going to be paid double for that either?
That has not been confirmed to me in FEMA, or I mean, or the state of Maine.
How would the grant amount be determined?
Say that again.
How would the grant amount be determined for each citizen?
The grant amount is going to be determined by Tiffany Parker, who came in. She's going to individually look at each site. And then based on what mitigation is allowed at that site, that's who's going to determine how much money you get for that house. So if it can be raised, you'll get that much. The house has to be torn down and reconstructed and raised, you'll get that amount.
So are you saying there's an evaluation process?
Yes.
That's all. So it's not determined by the fact that the individual wants the buyout, but it's also determined by Ms. Parker.
Well, they can sign up for the individual program. The individual programs, they determine the individual. It's not like they decide. I guess what I'm saying is if you signed up for the buyout, there's a process for the buyout. You signed up for, right, you have to qualify for it. So if you also sign up for the raising of homes, you have to qualify for that.
So there's a possibility, what percentage of that? Is there a great chance of that happening, or
they have,
is it hard to determine?
They have not said to me what that was.
Hard to determine.
Did the state bring in contract and do that?
They didn't say how they were going to do it. We're waiting for them. They're waiting for us to vote, but I told the board I don't think we should vote until they tell us what the base flood elevation is. So it's like a waiting game because you don't know how to mitigate the house.
But you're asking us now, you're saying that you want to wait until you get all the information from the state. But you're asking the citizens already to rebuild their homes and to move back into their homes as quickly as possible.
Right.
But you're saying now we don't have enough information to determine even the base flood elevation to determine if they're going to raise those properties to a certain level, correct?
Right. That's exactly what I'm doing. I want the citizens to come back, and I'm trying to make it safe. I want people to feel safe, but I have to get the base flood elevation back, and nobody can do anything until you get the base flood elevation. So nobody can do anything. So
Mr. Gerald, in the meeting that I had with my ward the other night, Ms. Parker did say that someone asked a question in regard to if they changed their mind, if they opt for, say, the buyout, and if they change their mind, because it'll be a 12 to, I believe it was 24-month wait before they would even start doing anything. But if they opt to change their mind, she said, if the bulldozers get ready to push your house down, and if they have not pushed it down yet, you can say right then, I changed my mind. Mm-hmm. So my question is, even though I understand we don't have the elevation numbers right now, is that something that as soon as we get that information, I think we have enough time to say to the citizens if they made a decision already that they want the elevation. If we say to them, this is what the state says the elevation needs to be, do you still want that?
We can be proactive that way. I mean, I did the same thing. I came to the board asking to raise it 2 feet above the base flood level. And we thought we had the number, but that wasn't the actual number. So, I mean, that's possible. We can do that.
How about the people that redone their homes already? What are you going to do about the elevation needed for them after they've already spent all this money to redo their homes?
Well, that's the thing.
They're still eligible.
You're still eligible to raise it. But, I mean, nobody's going to not do
it. Right, because you haven't applied for either one of those options. If someone has already had something done to their home, and then once the options are offered, then you'll be given an application to apply to have one of those options. So no one has applied for the options as of yet. So now if you apply for the option to have your home elevated, and you already had some work done to it, then you will be based on whether Ms. Parker, if you're eligible or not, then you'll be able to, that's when the mitigation will come into effect.
question. What if someone has already purchased a home and brought it in, and, you know, like it's hooked together, but it ain't pinned in, like bricked up or whatever. Can you still qualify for a grant?
That's still eligible.
For elevation,
yes.
For elevation.
But you still got to remember, her question is now, if yeah. she's already spent her flood money, are they going to allow her to accept the grant money if she's had replaced the money to replace her house with already?
For the elevation,
for
yes.
the elevation.
Up to 100. Yeah. For elevation.
But if you've already...
Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead and say it.
My understanding is from FEMA, all the meetings that I've been to, they have encouraged citizens to go back to your homes, rebuild whatever, and then once the council make their vote, and whatever you want to participate in, if they vote for all three and you decide you want to participate, then you can still participate in the mitigation program. That was the understanding I got.
That's how it worked.
At the school.
Mm-hmm. So that's how it worked.
There's no need to wait, because after the first of the year, I'm ready to go back and put my house back together. But once the council meets tonight, if they're going to decide tonight to participate in mitigation, whichever one, because I'm not going to participate in either one of them. My house is brick. They do two floors. I don't jack it up, might fall off pieces. If it again, hey, I'll build it back, whatever. But you cannot, because when you're dealing with the state might not give you an answer until 18 months from now as far as how high they want you to raise that house. So it's incumbent upon the council to make the decision, because if you don't hurry up and make that decision, they're gonna move on down the road. And you don't have to wait, Mr. Gerald, you don't have to wait. And because I'm not willing to wait another 12 months to go back to get my house in order. My husband is ill, I'm ready to get him back to his comfort zone. I already have to do some things to my house to accommodate him. So council, make your decision. You have the power to say what is and what's not, and whatever you say, then everybody else has to trail along behind it. But I'm not willing to wait until you hear from the state, because tell me, the state might be anytime.
Well, let's make this perfectly clear now. They want you to go back in now and repair your home.
Right.
You don't have to wait on our decision.
That's right.
They want you to go back in and repair your home so you have someplace safe and sound to go back to. They don't want you to stay in the hotels and the apartments for the next 18 months, 20, 24 months. They want you to go ahead and do what you need to do to get back in. Now, if you go back in and the elevation is where you put your house is too low, the grant will allow you to raise your home wherever it is. Okay? Yes?
In the meeting last week, I think she's, Ms. Parker said, not to quote her, but the average height, because I asked the question, what was the average height that they would probably be elevated, and she said 2 to 10 feet.
Mm-hmm. He said 2 to 12, is what he said.
That was what she said last week.
And she had the same information that we're sort of basing it on, but until we get something concrete from the state, and we don't want to say that's etched in stone what it is, but she did say that last week in that meeting we had. But
she said that the one that we had in Tarboro.
And she had to say that, the one we had, I had with my ward the other night as well.
Did the state give you a timeline on how long it's going to take? Could the governor say he wants to move quickly?
I talked to the governor's office. I actually talked to somebody in his cabinet on Saturday, and he said they want to move quickly. So if I don't get an answer tomorrow, I'm calling the governor's cabinet tomorrow. So I intend on having an answer to the council at least by Wednesday. I think that's the last day, but I'm by Wednesday. So we'll know how high the base for elevation is, because it's critical to get people back in there.
And here again is my position on whether or not for us tonight. My position is, I know that we do need that information. My position is that we do go ahead and vote, because things, just logically. You know, it's been a long time that we've been waiting to hear, that the citizens are waiting, and you just need to put people's heart at ease, I believe. Mm-hmm. Whether we say what they want to hear or not, I think we just need to put people's heart at ease and help people to be able to have an enjoyable Christmas as much as possible. I think that the longer we hold it in limbo, it ain't gonna change. My opinion, my decision is not gonna change, whether they said build it 20 feet in the air or whatever. But I think it's time that we do give the citizens something to start looking to their future for.
Well, I'd like to add something to this, to try to keep it as simple as possible without any confusion. We don't want to put the wagon before the mule, but there's another phase we need to look at before we really decide what we want to do as far as participating in the three options. Town manager and I went down to Wilmington and had a meeting with the Army Corps of Engineers. And had a very productive meeting up to a point. And I'm concerned with all the things we decide to do of those three. We need to make sure that something is done to that dike and that river. Because whatever you decide to do, if these precautions are not taken into serious consideration, you're going to have the same thing you got in 1999 and here. And they have a map that they have put together, whether it's the correct map or not. But I'm not satisfied as a resident myself who wants to stay. But if they couldn't show me where I'm going to be protected, then you are not protected. And I already made my mind up. I'm not trying to influence anybody. Whatever you decide to do, that's yours, and you got my prayers. But before we decide to do anything, we need to make sure that something is going to be done to that dog leg at Shiloh Landing and the continuance of that dike, as well as some reservoirs with some pumps to take that water out of Princeville. Don't have to dump it in over here in Tarboro. But we need to make sure that something is done before you decide to do anything. Lift your house, stay there, whatever. If nothing is done to the wound, it's gonna still continue to bleed. And that's where I stand, because like I said, I don't have any ulterior motives. No businesses to be thinking about, I got to stay here regardless of whatever. I'm using common sense and I'm thinking in your behalf when I be going to these meetings, because you're not getting the information that he and I, that we may be exposed to, but at the same time, you need to know about it before you make a decision to do anything.
So can you tell us tonight, you said you met with the Article Engineer in Wilmington.
Yeah.
Can you tell us tonight what is the projection?
What is the what now?
What is the projection for the dike? What is the projection to protect the citizens based on where we are right now?
Well, I had suggested at an earlier meeting with them, and they did not have it in the project, which was to alter the river at the bend. At the same time, continue the dike, which that's part of the project. But as far as having some reservoirs to hold that excess water and drain it over towards Tar River, where it can come in through a conduit pipe to get it out of get it out of Princeville. This was not part of the project. And I'm open for entertaining another engineer, if you got to go the way, because you got Barnhill here and you got Sancho, your guys you're talking to. And we just don't need to be letting someone dictate us with $2 billion going to be, not for Princeville, but for the whole Tar River Basin to make it safe. We need to get busy, like the mayor said, and get involved so that we can make sure that whatever is coming in this area will encompass East Harbor, because that's where the water comes in the back from that same dog leg. And when it gets full down there, it comes out of Tar River into Princeville. And all of this needs to be put on the plate to find out who's going to fix that before we build a doghouse over there.
If you're interested in the buyout, what's the level of the water got to do if you're interested in the buyout?
It doesn't have anything to do with it. Why couldn't that
process be go ahead and handle it instead of having to wait?
But you have that option to deal with.
Mr. Mayor.
Yeah, if I could say one other thing, I would like to add this to whoever that plans on staying in Princeville. Think about your health. Now, by the spring, that grass gonna be growing up, where a lot of that water has sink down in that ground. So you can't just get that dirt and wash it up like clothes. So someone need to really check the water deeper down in the ground to see if
it's healthy. Ms. Baker, now all that it would be in that plan of draining that water, that's standing water, because it's only 2 feet down and you can hit water. It was never nothing but a good farmland over there when they put our ancestors over there. And this debris that you see laying alongside the road after the cleanup with the big trucks, we have a young man in here tonight that's ready to really take that on with his team if we can meet and decide, because that too is looking bad. It looks like litter starting from the railroad track. People driving through here, and I'm here, and they say, Mr. Bullock, it makes me feel so sad. I said, I know it, dude. I'm over there now, and I'm living in it. But after a while, it's going to start fuming off mold and toxic stuff that when you come back, you're going to be breathing it. But Mr. Frank, yes, we'll be talking with him later on because he has a company that would be willing to come and do the cleanup. And we wanted to ask the churches if they have any. We have any ministers here tonight? Not. Talk to them and see if they can't supply or ask some of their church members, do you have a trailer to pick up the small debris and put it in the big bags? And then we wanted to approach Eric Evans, the county manager, if he could waiver the fee of carrying it to the landfill. But we need to clean up that the street. Yes.
Mr. Mayor.
I'd like to know, what is it that the county has a contract and Princeville should be included in that contract? Why is it that you're having so much trouble with picking up debris? And I'm going to tell you this right now. Until this council make a decision as to which route they're going, the Honor Corps of Engineers, because the Honor Corps of Engineers will get their direction from this council. After this council makes a decision, you will see a lot of difference. Then you have something to wait with. You can go to them and say, our citizens want to come back, the majority of them are driven back, and this is what we want. We need drainage, we need the river basin, we need all of this. So until you make until they make their decision, you're going to have
Okay, we have an answer to that. We are doing right now, we do actually have an engineer that's actually studying the problem right now, as we speak. And they're actually doing the FEMA, some of the FEMA work, Category A, Category C, D, G work. And that also is going to encompass something with the dike. I don't want to say too much about it right now. I just want to wait until the report comes out. And additionally, with the trash.
The Honor Corps of Engineers money, most of it comes from, it's federal.
That's right.
Most of it is federal, and that's where the $3 million before came from. And that was the reason why in 99, it came to a point, make your decision, because it's going to be, if you don't hurry up and make a decision, the money's going to roll on somewhere else. So that's why I said the council needs to make their decision.
Well,
and then you can start pushing for mitigation for the town, for drainage, for all of this stuff.
Well, there is no upfront money, but we are pushing for mitigation.
I'm not talking about upfront.
There is no $1 million that, like whatever happened in 99, if they said y'all had $3 million or whatever towards the dike, there's nothing like that available, but there are mitigation dollars.
I just saw Erica England's web page, the amount of money that has been put in for mitigation, for dams, river basins, drainage.
That's mitigation. That's what I'm saying. So that's the money we're going to be applying for mitigation.
Right. So that's why I said you know, until the council, they're waiting for the council to make their decision. The council in 99 was in a meeting, and a knock on the back door said, you guys need to make a decision, because.
Well, here's what the engineering contract, the engineering report should be done January 3rd or January 4th. That's going to have any and all mitigation requests.
Has any of that changed since 2014 when they completed the reverse report?
That report that you're talking about is by the Corps, I believe. This is, to my knowledge, the first engineering contract that addressed the Corps' engineering. So we're back checking the Corps' findings and operations and designs.
One more question. I don't remember you answered this young man back here when he said about the buyout. Since the buyout don't have to go through all that procedure about staying, why can't they push that up so it'll be shorter time for the buyout?
Even if you don't have to do meet base flood elevations, it's still going to take 18 to 24 months.
But can you go on putting progress? Don't y'all have to accept? Don't Princeville have to let whoever that is
get something moving?
The buyout. Let them know that the town is interested in the buyout, so that they can push that further along.
Yeah. Well, I'm recommending we get the information. And we should have everything January. We're going to have mitigation meetings, I think, sometime in February. So,
but I thought once y'all vote on all three, that y'all pass.
You're still going to have to wait until February 13th. Okay. Or February 14th. That's Valentine's Day. Then that's where they're going to put together all the requests. And then you're going to have another meeting in March.
So then, in that case, we can have a special call meeting if necessary.
We may have one as soon as I get the engineering report.
Why would they wait that long if?
I don't know. That's the email that I got today.
Don't the town board have to vote on that they're going to accept the buyout or the?
Yes, we need to be registered.
Y'all are voting on tonight. Couldn't you put that forth a little bit?
It won't go any faster. I mean, it still won't move until February 14th.
Well, look, I know it's going to take a long time to get everything done. What's going to happen to the people?
Where are
we going to be?
That's what I'm discussing right now. I know a lot of displaced residents have gotten letters saying that January 7th is the last day. I've gotten verbal confirmation from FEMA saying they're not going to put anyone out on the streets. Nobody's going to be put out on the street. Okay. And actually, there's a FEMA liaison that deals with public affairs that's actually coming into the town hall either this week or next week. So they're going to make sure that we don't have displaced citizens. My frustration with the state is that they need to go ahead and give us the information so we can move forward with everybody's request.
I got a question.
I got one.
Look, could I? Yeah. How are you raising up 10 feet off the ground? Some of these people got sick people and their family people in wheelchairs and things. They have to have a ramp 200 feet long to try to get up.
We were actually discussing that. We were discussing that, and we were talking about the pros and cons of lifts. So I don't have a good answer for you, but that is being discussed. About our elderly population.
So what is the actual disadvantage if the council were to vote on all three options? Then you have every single option on the table, and every single individual who has been affected by the flood can make their own personal decision within that 18-month period of time. I mean, why don't we continue to procrastinate on a decision that the board can make and allow all three options, and then the citizen will have that responsibility now placed back on them versus that decision being placed back on the board, because all three options at this point in time will be allowed. Because, I mean, we're saying the same thing. We're saying you don't have the information to make a decision about elevation, reconstruction, or buyout. But you have enough decision ability on that board to simply say, listen, we can simply allow everything as an option. And we can move this process forward.
Well, let me make sure I explain this to everybody. We have a town and 2,200 citizens that we are working for.
Mr. Jones,
May I finish?
You have finished this time and time again.
But you keep asking the same question. You keep asking the same question. I'm giving you the same response.
No. My question is, why can't we make a decision? That's my first time ever asking that question, Mayor.
Because he just explained to you, it doesn't matter whether we make it today or by February 13th, nothing's going to move forward until the 14th when you turn it in.
So, you don't think the citizen deserves some peace of mind? Because you know now that you have all three options, or you don't have but one option, and from tonight forward, you can make some type of plan, like the council person just simply said. She said, listen, once you give the person some direction, even if you do nothing, at least you have the opportunity to wait on doing nothing because you make a decision. But not having a decision, the people don't know. And it's extremely stressful to continue to keep waiting, not knowing if you're going to accept one or three other options. If you make one of them, the council has made a decision and we can move forward. But you keep saying you have to get all the information. We understand it. Ashcombe County has to get all the information. The town of Tarboro has to get all the information. The city of Rocky Mount has to get all the information. But every meeting I've attended, the board has simply said, if it's available, we're going to allow our citizens to participate. And they don't have any more information than you all have. Nothing else.
But they haven't voted, though.
They haven't voted, but they said they will accept it at each public meeting they've gone to.
The fact of the matter, you're making a valid point, but you're not looking at Princeville. Princeville may not be able to survive a buyout if a lot of people take it because it's a small piece of property. And that's just the bottom line.
It's being offered to us.
And I think that the council then we need to accept right now about the people that have signed up, who's interested in the buyout. And like I told the mayor, there are about 25 homes in the center of Princeville, but they're outside of the city limits. That's being Mullen Street, 2nd Street, 1st Street. Those houses are homeowners, and they're right in the middle of Princeville, but they're out of the city limits. And Cathedral, part of Cathedral Street. So if you have 25 people to leave, all you have to do is annexation. Annexation on 258. I don't want to have to wait for you all to, for February, for you all to start to say that I can't come and get a permit to go on and put my house back together. You know, I mean, hey.
You can go get your permit to put it back together.
So the way Mr. Gerald is saying, you can't do anything until you get your information. So
No. You can rebuild your home now.
If I want to go on the first of the year, get permit.
If you say you're not doing anything to your house, so if you're not doing anything to your house, you only get your permit and tear it out, gut it, put the stuff on the side of the road. You see, that's a lot of the issues with the trash. You don't have a lot of people cleaning the homes out at the same time.
Well, my house is cleaned out. All I have to do is wait to get all of my contractors in.
Well, that's all you got to do.
Come in. That's all I want.
And anybody that's in your situation, that's all they would have to do.
That's all I want to do.
Mr. Mayor, I just want to add, I hear the conversation about not knowing the elevation. Now, I want to add this piece to it. Now, I'm going through the same thing with my dad. I was living in the house in 99, but my dad living in it now. So I'm trying to put the house back together, to work around him, decide on what he want to do, whatever make him comfortable. But I just met with Samaritan Purse on Monday night. They will come in, if you eligible, especially somebody in the upper age, like 75, 80 years old, they will come in, they will either tear your house down, put another one on that same spot for free, or if you find some land, they'll go build it on that lot. But for the houses going back in the flood area, they must know the elevation. So right now, nobody knows the elevation. So you got people willing to come in and give you free houses if you qualify. But they got to know the elevation. I'm going through it with my dad right now, and I'm in Byron Road in Pine Top. I'm not in Princeville. But that's why I come on this committee and going around traveling so I can take you all. Although I got an opinion of my own, but I'm also going to take the people's, and they're watching my video. I went to the meeting in Pine Top the other night where they were departing the people that came and tore out the houses and the new crew coming in, and they were looking at my video. So they're watching what's going on. But I just want you to know the elevation piece is very important because people could be getting free houses right now if they knew the elevation, whether you're going to have to raise your house or whatever. So it plays a part. And I have been
sort of quiet because I didn't want to say anything, but what I'm saying is I understand people want you to move forward right now, but I just don't understand business-wise how you can move forward without all the information, because if you give people false hope and then you come back and you say, well, I got to raise my house 12 feet, and then you don't want to raise your house 12 feet. And the other thing, like the people said in the meeting the other week, now, what you got to understand, Princeville, the people here can't pay this high-priced flood insurance. So you got places that flood all the time. But those people get new houses, new furniture and stuff because they're paying high flood insurance. So the decision is whether you love Princeville, you want to come back to Princeville and live here knowing the flood could come. Because working on the dike and all that kind of stuff, what wonder if a flood come before they even do it? I mean, how long is that going to take? They ain't going to do it overnight. So I'm just saying you all got to think this thing out. And see, you talk about two different things when you're talking about renters and you're talking about homeowners. So you got to take everything in consideration. It ain't just about you. And like I'm telling y'all now, you can say what you want to about me, but I'm going through it. My dad, he live with me right now, and he's frustrated. I'm frustrated. But that's why I come on out here, making sure you all get the correct information. People that ain't here tonight, they'll be able to go on my video and see what you're saying, what I'm saying, what the boy's saying. I just want the correct information to get out.
Well, Mr. Dennison, I would like to say thank you so very much for that keynote information that you have shared, because I think there is some confusion. But however, we thank you for sharing that, because you being on that committee to bring it out pertaining to the evaluate.
Mr.
Jerry. Thank you,
sir.
Can
you contact the county manager? I had some tire washed over there when the flood came. I got my side of the road now, and the man we're picking up with the truck said it won't call for the flood. But when the water came, it washed up on him and yonder. How can he establish it came from the flood? Now, I don't know what in the contract. I don't know what in the contract, but you should look at that contract and see what pick up what is what. Because he refused to pick some tire from my area. As a matter of fact, I see some more tiles in other areas. But I see he bypassed. But I don't know why the county got in the contract. Get in contact with the county and find out why they're not picking up the debris we washed out from him from there, from the flood.
I'll talk to the county manager.
I would like to say that I know we keep talking about the town and the tax base, but I think our main concern should be the safety of the citizens and those who, you know, feel obligated to come back because that's something they know they own. But will they be able to elevate high enough so that the next flood, because I had 8 to 9 feet of water in my house. If I elevate 10 feet, I might make it the next time. So I'm saying we should be concerned about the lives of those people. You know, we know that it has a history of flooding, and it's getting closer, because I heard that there was one in 58 and then 99 and then now 2016. The floods are getting closer. We don't want to have to keep, though, and anybody who wants to stay is fine, but I think that all options should be put on the table for each homeowner. Mm-hmm. I think they should be able to make the decision that's best for their family. And I think if the board makes a decision tonight to accept all three options, then when we sit down and say, well, buyout's not going to be best for me, maybe I need to elevate. They can make an informed decision because they have put all options on the table. I think if we keep holding off, then we might miss something.
Not gonna miss anything.
But I say it like this, sir. The way I am now, people ask me, Angela, what are you gonna do? I said, I'm waiting on Princeville to decide what they're gonna do.
And like I said, like you said, your house flooded 8 feet. The mitigation process is designed to take care of that.
Right. And
it all depends upon what the base flood level of your house is now and what it's going to. And I agree. I'm just as frustrated as you are, because this is not a question I just was asking. This is a question we were asking in October.
Right. So, and I mean, the height, we can work on that later.